The binomial distribution, which is a type of discrete probability distribution, consists of the probabilities of the outcomes of a binomial experiment. And these experiments come from probability problems that have only two outcomes, or can be reduced to two outcomes. For instance, a coin flip can be either a head or a tail. And on a test, a multiple choice question can be reduced to correct or incorrect. There are four requirements for a binomial experiment. Number one is that there must be a fixed number of trials. Number two is that each trial can have only two outcomes or be reduced to two outcomes. And these are often referred to as a success or a failure. Number three is that the outcomes of each trial must be independent of one another. And number four is that the probability of a success must be the same for each trial. Binomial probability is the probability of X successes in N trials. For instance, if you toss a coin three times, what is the probability of getting exactly two heads? Checking this problem against the binomial requirements, there are a fixed number of trials, in this case three trials. There are only two outcomes for each trial, heads or tails, and we could term getting a head as a success and a tail as a failure. The outcome of each trial is independent, as no toss has any effect on another toss, and the probability of success, getting a head, is the same for each trial. There is a 50% probability of getting a head on each trial. There are two main ways to find the probability of our question. The first is to use a tree diagram and the addition rule, as you see here. And the probability equals 3 over 8, or 0.375. The second way to find the probability is to use the binomial probability formula. The formula for getting exactly x successes in n trials is probability of x equals n factorial divided by n minus x factorial times x factorial times p to the x times q to the n minus x. This formula may look a bit intimidating, but it's actually not that bad if you break it down, and we'll use our probability question to do that. So, probability of x is the probability of x successes. In our problem, this is the probability of getting two heads in three tosses. So p of x equals two heads. In the formula, n equals the number of trials. And in our problem, there are three trials. So n equals three. In the formula, x equals the number of successes. And in the problem, we're looking for two successes. So x equals two. In the formula, p equals the probability of success in an individual trial. And in our problem, the probability of a success, getting a head on the flip, is 50%, or 1 over 2. And in the formula, q equals the probability of a failure in a single trial, which is 1 minus p, which equals 50%, or 1 over 2. Now we have all that we need, so we plug into the formula. Probability of two heads equals 3 factorial divided by 3 minus 2 factorial times 2 factorial times 1 over 2 squared times 1 over 2 to the 3 minus 2. And calculating this out, we get 3 over 8, or 0.375, same as the tree diagram. As an example, let's say you took a poll and found that 80% of people check their phone during their workout. If you select 10 people at random, what is the probability that exactly 5 of them check their phone during their workout? So, first we need to check that this fits the requirements for the binomial experiment. There are a fixed number of trials, in this example 10. It does consist of just two outcomes, check their phone or not check their phone. Each of the 10 trials is independent of one another, and yes, the probability for success is the same for each trial. In this case, checking their phone during a workout is a success with a probability of 80%, or 0.80. Now that we know it meets the requirements, we can use the formula. So first we need to assign all of our notations for the formula. We need to assign n, x, p, and q. N equals the number of trials, and in the question we're looking at 10 trials. X equals the number of successes in the n, or 10 trials, and that number is 5, which is given in the question. P is the probability of success, and that is 80%, or 0.80. And Q is the probability of failure, which is 1 minus P, which equals 20%, or 0.20. And now we're ready to plug and calculate. So we have probability of X, or probability of 5 successes, equals 10 factorial divided by 10 minus 5 factorial times 5 factorial times 0.80 raised to the 5th times 0.20 raised to the 10 minus 5. I have written the calculation out for this on the screen, and the result is 0.0264, or 2.6%. So there is a 2.6% probability of randomly selecting exactly 5 people out of 10 that check their phone during their workout. And we can reword the question to get a different perspective. Using the same data, 80% check their phone, if you randomly select 10 people, what is the probability that at least 7 of them check their phone during their workout? In this question, at least 7 means 7, 8, 9, or 10. So in this case, we need to calculate the individual probabilities and add them up to get the total probability. In using the formula in each of these cases, n will be 10, p will be 0.80, q will be 0.20, and x will change values, 7, 8, 9, and 10. I have the calculations for each of these cases on the screen. Adding these up, we get 0.879, or 87.9%. As a note, here are all the possible values for x, 1 through 10, along with their probabilities. If we add these up, we get 0.99974. If I had not rounded them off, the result would have been 1. So this checks out because the sum of the probabilities is equal to 1. We can also compute the mean, variance, and standard deviation for a binomial distribution, and these formulas are listed here. To find the mean, we need to know two things, n, the number of trials, and p, the probability of success. Using our same data, 80% of people check their phone during a workout. If we randomly selected 1,000 individuals, what would the mean be? So mu, the mean, equals n, in this case 1,000, times p, 0.80, which equals 800. And the variance would be sigma squared equals n, 1,000, times p, 0.80, times q, which again is 1 minus p, or 0.20. And this computes to 160. And to find the standard deviation, we take the square root of the variance, square root of 160, which equals 12.65. All right, my friends, that be the basics on the binomial distribution. Hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.